This is a story called The Little Monsters, Chapter 66, The Scooter and the Go-Kart Race. It's the school summer holidays and the kids are all at the go-kart tracks when a member of the staff announced that in about 3 weeks' time there's going to be a go-kart race. They tell everyone that they can't buy or borrow their go-karts. They have to design and build their own. The gang love building things from scratch and they can't wait to get started. Of course, they can't take part in the race together, they have to do it individually. They get to work building their own go-karts to enter in the race. They don't even help each other to build their go-karts, they do it themselves. A couple of days after they heard about the go-kart race, they were at the new skate park and they saw a notice saying that there was going to be a scooter race on the following Saturday. So they put their names down for it. The kids worked really hard making their go-karts. They were allowed to help themselves to whatever they needed in Stumpy's dad's workshop, as he owned his own business designing and making wood sheds and tree houses and everything wooden. He also let them take metal bolts and stuff to help keep their go-karts together. On the day of the scooter race, everyone was told that they had to wear their helmets, knee pads and elbow pads for safety. They were told that if they didn't, they wouldn't be able to take part. The race started at 2 p.m. and they had to go all the way round the skate park and over the bumps. The winner would receive a £300 shopping voucher and a brand new scooter and skateboard or a pair of new skates of their choice. The second place winner would win a scooter of their choice and a £150 shopping voucher. As soon as the whistle blew, the race started. Everyone went round the whole park and over the ramps brilliantly. When they got halfway round, Kicker and the little bully, Timothy, were way out in front for a while. Then two other kids took over them. They were doing really well until Kicker and Timothy took over them. The first person to cross over the finish line was Kicker. She chose a new pair of roller skates with flashing lights. Timothy came second and he chose a brand new scooter also with flashing lights, and he received a £150 shopping voucher and Kicker received a £300 shopping voucher. Kicker decided that she wanted to share her voucher with the rest of the gang. They all spent their share on a pair of skates each and of course some more joke stuff. After the race, the kids decided to stay and play for a bit. Even Timothy stayed and played with them for a bit. When they left the skate park, they all went and played at the swing for a bit. Then they all went back to Stumpy's to play for a bit, Timothy including. Whilst they were there, Stumpy's dad asked Timothy if he was entering the go-kart race, and he said no because he had nothing to build a go-kart with. Stumpy's dad gave him some wood and everything he needed to build a go-kart. Then Creeper said, "My dad's a mechanic and he owns his own garage. He said yesterday that he has some old metal that we can use, like nuts and bolts. Let's go to my house and ask him if we can take them." They made their way to Creeper's house and her dad took them to his garage and gave them bits and bobs that they needed. None of them knew what each of his go-karts looked like because they all wanted to surprise each other on the day of the race. They all worked really hard building them, even Timothy. Once their go-karts were built and ready to use, their dads made sure that they were all safe and they tightened the nuts and bolts for them to make sure that they wouldn't come loose and cause them to have an accident. Once they were made safe, the kids tested them out so that they could get used to them. Of course, they did this when they went with each other. On the day of the race, it was announced that There would be three races, each with 10 kids in it. Timothy was in the first race along with Bumpy and Creeper, and he came first. He won a year's worth of free entry, including free go-kart hire to the go-kart track and a £200 shopping voucher. Kicker and Stumpy were in the second race, and Stumpy came first and received the same prize as Timothy. Stumpy and Grumpy were in the last race, and Grumpy won, and he also got the same prize as Timothy. After the races, they were all told that they could use the go-kart tracks until closing time, free of charge. When they closed at 6:30 p.m, everyone went home. The next day, they all went back to the go-kart tracks, and the staff announced that there was going to be another race the following week, on the day before they go back to school. Of course, the three previous winners weren't allowed to enter, but the others were. On the day of the race, Stumpy won first prize, which was the same as the previous winners. Afterwards, they stayed at the tracks for a bit, and then they all went back to Kicker's house for tea, even Timothy. After tea, they all went to the skate park, and Timothy borrowed one of Kicker's skateboards. They stayed there until about 5:30 p.m, and then they all went and played at the swing for a bit. The next day, they went back to school, but after school, they all went back to the go-kart tracks for a couple of hours. They went home a bit earlier than normal because it was raining and they didn't want to get wet. The next day it was still raining, so they all played at Kicker's house for a bit. For the rest of that week it continued to rain, so they just played at each of his houses. Even over the weekend, when the rain stopped, they were able to go back to the go-kart track. End of chapter 66. Thanks for watching, guys. Love ya. Bye.